The topic we'll be discussing today is based on converse, inverse, contrapositive, and logical implications under the concepts of fundamentals of logic. So let us see regarding the converse, inverse, and contrapositive. So for example, consider the conditional P conditional Q. Okay, consider this particular conditional P conditional Q. Q conditional P is nothing but the converse of P conditional Q. That's what I wrote. See, conditional P is called the converse of P conditional Q, and the inverse of this P conditional Q is written as negation P conditional negation Q, and it is called inverse. And contrapositive is nothing but negation of Q conditional negation of P. So I'll just write here, P conditional is a normal conditional. The converse of this will be Q conditional P, and the inverse will be negation of P conditional negation of Q, and the contrapositive will be negation of Q conditional negation of P. So this is how the inverse, converse, and contrapositive is being noted. So now let us see regarding the truth tables for these converse, inverse, and contrapositive. You know that PQ, negation P and negation Q, you know how to write it. P conditional Q, you know when it is 1, 0, it is false. So I have written here P conditional Q is 1, 0. 1 it is 1, 0 it is 0. What about Q conditional P? Try to put here conditional. Second row you'll get it 0. Rest all the cases it is 1. We know based on the truth table concept. So you got this 1, 0 will be 0. Then all the cases it will be 1. Now what is negation P conditional negation Q? Check for 1 zeros. You have over here 1 zeros. Rest all it will be 1 based on the conditional property. So 1 0. So you know here you'll get it as 0. What about negation Q conditional negation P? For this you'll get it as 0. So third row is 0. So this is how you're going to see the truth table. By based on this truth table, you can see that a conditional and its contrapositive, this conditional and contrapositive, both are logically equivalent because the truth value is same. So they are both are logically equivalent. Agree? And the converse and inverse, check for converse and inverse, these both are also logically equivalent. Logically equivalent. So a conditional and its contrapositive are logically equivalent, as well as the converse and inverse are also logically equivalent. So you should know what is a converse. Converse is nothing but Q conditional P. Inverse is negation P conditional negation Q. And contrapositive is nothing but negation Q conditional negation P. So this is based on the truth table of the converse, inverse, and contrapositive. I hope you're clear with the definition section. Now let us begin with the problem. They're told that write down the contrapositive of P conditional Q conditional R, that is contrapositive. So you know what is contrapositive. By the definition I'll tell what is a contrapositive. They're told that write down the contrapositive of P conditional Q conditional R with only one occurrence of the connective and no occurrence of the connective. First they told that you write in only one occurrence. Next they have told that with no occurrence of the connective. So it will be nothing but, you know what is P conditional Q? This is the normal conditional. What is the contrapositive of this? Contrapositive is nothing but negation Q conditional negation P. If you see the definition, contrapositive is written as negation Q conditional negation P. So what will be the contrapositive of this particular term? So just write what is the contrapositive. The contrapositive of contrapositive of P conditional Q conditional R is nothing but, this is your Q, right? So it is negation of Q conditional R conditional negation of P. So this is your one section. I mean, you just, this contrapositive of this is nothing but, this is the contrapositive. So first they told write down the contrapositive of this. Then they told with only one occurrence of conditional. Here we have two occurrence of the conditional. Here we have two occurrence of the conditional. I should remove it and make only one occurrence of the conditional. So I can write this contrapositive. I'll write it over here. Okay, I'll write it over here. That is nothing but negation of Q conditional R conditional negation of P. So this is the contrapositive. They told make sure A problem, A, I wrote A, only one occurrence of the connective. So I'll remove this particular connective. What is this actually? It is in the form of P conditional Q. It is not of negation of all P conditional Q. This has one negation, this has negation. So it is P conditional Q. So what will be the formula for this? It is nothing but negation of, you know, what is the formula for P conditional Q? It is nothing but negation of P or Q. So here you'll get negation of Q conditional R conditional, this conditional I replaced, or this is or Q instead of Q we have negation of P. So you know that this can be further solved it to nothing but Q conditional R or negation of P, Q conditional R or negation of P. So first problem we got only one occurrence of the connective. Next they told no occurrence of the connective. So we can solve same way, no occurrence, same way. Here I'll solve, what is the, just solve for Q and conditional R. What will be Q conditional R? It is nothing but negation Q or R or negation P. So here you can write, first one, only one occurrence, here with no occurrence of the connective. Okay, so here they have told write down the contrapositive of P conditional Q conditional R. You know what is contrapositive. You write it in this way: negation Q conditional negation P. Then they have told only one occurrence of the connective and then no occurrence of the connective. So this is how we are going to write the example one. Next example is based on the concept of logical implication. Before we see logical implication, I'll just give an example of conditional, because we know what is a conditional principle. So just we'll assume a conditional example. Let us take P and Q two proposition. Let us write P is nothing but 4 is an odd integer. 4 is an odd integer. 4 is an odd integer. And Q will write it as Bangalore is not in Karnataka. Okay, let us just write Bangalore is not in Karnataka. Bangalore is not in Karnataka. So you know that whether this is a true proposition, 4 is an odd integer. Obviously 4 is not an odd integer, so it is a false proposition. Bangalore is not in Karnataka, Bangalore is in Karnataka, but this is also false proposition. But according to your conditional principle, 0 conditional 0 gives 1. So that is nothing but this P conditional Q will get the truth value as 1. But if you write a statement, if 4 is an odd integer, then Bangalore is not in Karnataka. Whether your compound proposition makes any sense, logically it may be true, but whether your compound proposition makes any sense, if 4 is an odd integer, then Bangalore is not in Karnataka. So it doesn't make any sense. So over here, this is the principle of conditional. But now, if you want to write the implicative statements, or implicative statements are also called as hypothetical statement, then we must say that P and Q must be related to each other. This P and Q, right, that should be related in some way, so that the truth value of Q depends on the truth value of P, or as the truth value of P depends on the truth value of Q. So whenever the P and Q is related to each other, that is the truth value of Q is related to the truth value of P, and the truth value of P is related to the truth value of Q, such conditionals are called hypothetical statements. For let us take a statement like, when a statement is like P conditional Q, when a hypothetical statement is like P conditional Q, such that Q is true whenever P is true. Q is true whenever P is true. We say that P logically implies Q. Symbol is this: P logically implies Q. I'll repeat the statement. Whenever a hypothetical statement P conditional Q is such that Q is true whenever P is true, we say that P logically implies Q. This symbol is written as P logical implication Q. The symbol denoting this is nothing but the implication. Okay, so one more way, when a hypothetical statement P conditional Q such that Q necessarily may not be true, or Q necessarily true whenever P is true. Okay, when we say that Q is not necessarily true whenever P is true, that means this is not logically implying to Q. This is the statement that is does not imply, P does not imply Q. P does not imply Q definition is nothing but Q is not necessarily true whenever P is true. Q is true whenever P is true, then it is this implies. This not implies. So Q is true whenever P is true, then it is logically implication. Q is not true when P is true, it is not implication. Logically not implication. So this is how we are going to solve the problem. So let us solve the problems based on these concepts in the next page. So prove the following they are mentioned. That means what? You need to prove that this is true. Okay, Q is true. Q is true when this entire statement is true. That means what? P and P should be one, then this also should be one. Whenever, wherever in the truth table, this should be one, this also should be one. This is one, this also should be one. So if that both are one, I mean if this is one and you get the answer this also one, then it means that this logically implies this. Meaning is nothing but this, we say that P entire term, this logically implies this, this logically implies this, this logically implies this. So you might have seen in the logical equivalence notation was this. The logical equivalence notation was this. So for example, if you got 1001, here also you should get 1001. But in this logical implications, right, logical implication, what they are telling is, in case if this is true, this also should be true. Okay, if this is in one row, you might get one possible way, you might get this is true. If this is false, if this is true and if you get this false, then it is not logically implicated. If this is true and you get this also to be true, then this is logically implication. So let us solve the problem in the new page. So prove the following they have told. Prove the following. The first question is nothing but, the first question is based on, write down the question over here. Prove the following they are told. P and P conditional Q that logically implies Q. This is our first question. Second question they are told is P conditional Q and negation of Q. Okay, that is conditional of negation of P. And the third question they have told is P or Q and negation of P that logically implies Q. That logically implies Q. So we are proving this using again the truth table itself. So let us first prepare the truth table for this. Just see the terms. What are the terms we have over here? We have P, P conditional Q, Q, negation Q, negation P. So just write the truth table over here. So it is P, Q, I need a negation P, I need a negation Q. Okay, I need a negation P, I need a negation Q, and then I need a P conditional. I need P conditional Q or else or Q is also there. Or Q, then I need a P conditional Q. Okay. P conditional Q. So what I can do over here is just write down the values of P and Q. Otherwise, okay, we'll just write down the value of P and Q over here. Put a line over here. Is nothing good. We'll just write here 0 0 0 1 1 0 1. Yeah. Just write all the terms over here. I'll tell what you're supposed to do. Negation of P will be 1, 1, 0, 0. Negation of Q will be 1, 0, 1, 0. P or Q is nothing but, you know, here it is 0. Rest all 1, 1. P conditional Q is what? For this third row it is 0. Rest all it is 1, 1. Now, first term they have told. P and P conditional Q. If you want, you write here. P and P conditional Q. P and P conditional Q. Just write what is this term. P and P conditional Q. First one. P and P conditional Q. This. This and this. So you know 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So you'll get it as 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. P and P conditional Q. So it's telling that whenever P and P conditional Q, check for Q is true. If this is true, check whether Q is true. Yes, it is true. You can see that. That means you can see that whenever P and P, what is the meaning of logical implication? Whenever P is true, then Q is true. That's why this notation, if all the terms are need to be equivalent to Q, all the terms, all these values need to be equivalent to this Q value, then it will be, you can use logical equivalence. Whenever P is, this term is true, then this will be true. That's why we are using implication. So you check, this is true and this term is true. So from the table we find that when both, that means when P and P conditional Q are true, then Q is true. This proves that P and, you need to write the statement, okay, P and P conditional Q logically. Okay, what are the statements you need to write? We found that when P and P conditional is true, then Q is true. This proves that this and this is logically implying to Q. Next, if you want, you write here, next is P conditional Q and negation of Q. Just write down the values. P conditional Q and negation of Q. So this is P conditional Q and negational of Q. You know that 1, 0 is 0. Right, 1, 0 is 1, 0 is 0. Rest all the cases it is 1. So here again 1, 0 is there. So this is 0. So this is 1. So check for P conditional and negation of Q. P conditional Q and negation of Q. So here if this is 1, negation of P should be true. If this is 1, negation of P should be true. Check here. So here, over here, we found that P conditional Q, when P conditional Q and negation of Q, P conditional Q and negation of Q. Wait 1 minute. P conditional Q was over here. P conditional Q was over here. 1, 1, 0, 1. And the negation of Q. We did and negation of Q. So what we are, I think I did a mistake for this particular term. 1 minute. P conditional Q is over here and negation of Q. This we got 1 and 1. 1 and 1 and 1. This is 1. P conditional Q and 1 and 1. 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. So here also it should be 0. I made a mistake. So here you can see this term and, so it was 0. So this is what we'll get, the truth table. So what we have to prove, when this is true, your negation Q also should be true. Whether it is true, yes. So you know that therefore P conditional Q and negation of Q logically implies negation of Q. Okay, P conditional Q and negation of Q logically implies Q. So that is nothing but you found this value, you got 1 over here. When here you got 1, this also, negation of P also should be 1. Negation of P also should be 1. So check over here. When you have 1 over here, your negation of P is also 1. Negation of P is also 1. This is second question what I solved. I wrote this term over here. Try to solve P conditional Q and negation Q. So I did P conditional Q and negation of Q. So that is nothing but 1 and 1 is only 1. Rest all 0. So when here it is true, check whether this is true. Here it is true. So this is also true. So this, here it is P, okay, not Q. Here it is P. I wrote it as, I consider it as negation Q. So it is actually negation P. So when this is true, This is true, even this is true. So that is regarding the second equation. Last one is nothing but this term, P or Q and negation of P. You have to prove in place this, okay? So just write there. P or Q, what is P or Q? P or Q is over here. And negation of P, means you have to do and with this. P or Q and with this. So 1, 0, I cannot. 1, 1. So only second row is 1. Third row is, fourth row is 0. So just write 0, 0, 0. Now check. P, here you got 1, right? When this is true, check whether this is true. Q, check for Q. So yes, Q is true. So this is also proved that P or Q and negation P, if this is true, that is from the table we find that P or Q and negation P are true, then Q is true. So this proves that P or Q and negation of P logically implies Q. So this is how we are going to solve. Don't get confused with the logical equivalence, because logical equivalence means what? Entire this value should be equivalent to the Q value. Logical implication is what? When this is true, this must be true. When this is true, this must be true. So you check here, you got second row, this is true, this must be true. If this was zero, right, in case if this was zero, then here this will be not implication. Okay, so this is the meaning of logical implication. So let us solve the last problem in this section. Okay, they are told again, prove the following by using the logical implication concept itself. So let us solve in a new page. So our question is nothing but P or Q or R, and this is and negation of Q, P or Q or R and negation of Q, that logically implies P or R. So let us write the truth table first. We'll write P, write Q here, we'll write R, then we'll write negation of Q we need, then we need Q or R. One second. In the problem has P or Q or R and negation of Q, that is logically equivalent to P or R. So PQR I need and P or, okay, I'll write Q or R over here, QRR over here, then you can write like P or Q or R, okay, P or Q or R. This is the required, see, P I wrote, Q I wrote, R I needed, negation Q I wrote, then I wrote Q or R, then I wrote this entire term. Now let us write this entire term, P or Q or R and negation of Q. Then we need this term also, right, for logical implication. We'll write a particular term, so we'll try to solve this entire problem. Manage with the lines one. This is the entire term. Okay, so line. I'll just put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we'll just write the values. So you know how to write P, 4 zeros followed by 4 ones, 2 zeros followed by 2 ones, then alternate 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1, negation of Q it is there, it is 1 1 0 0 1 1 0 0. Next you have Q or R, so check where you have 0 0. Q or R, you know how it is, when both are 0 it is 0. So in the first row it is 0. Next you check here, it is 0. Rest all the cases it is 1. just write as it is QR. Okay, next you have P or Q or R. So you can check here. Only in this case, first row it is 0. Rest all the cases it is 1 because we don't have any where it is 0. Here it is not there. Here 1 and 0. So only the first row it is 0. Rest all it will be 1. So write as it is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Next it is P or this with and negation of Q. And negation of Q. So first row it is 0. Second row it is 1. This is 0. Fourth row also it is 0. Next again 2 ones. Next again 2 zeros. Okay, next again. That is 01 00 11 00. Next it is P or R. P or R. So P or R, you know, first row it is 0. First row it is 0. P or R. Rest. Third row it is 0. So P or R, first row it is 0 and third row it is 0. So 0, 1, 0, rest all it is 1. Rest all it is 1. Now what you have to prove, whenever this is true, this also should be true. So check here, second row it is true, this is true. Check here, this is true, this is true. Check here, this is true, this is true. Whenever this is true, this is also true. So you can see in the second row, in second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. In second row, fifth and sixth. From rows 2, 5, 6 of the table, we observe that if this is true, if this is true, then this is true. So this proves that this is logically implication to this particular P or R. This is the concept of logical implication. Thank you.